Let's look at decomposing a vector into two orthogonal vectors. So first we need to remember that orthogonal just means perpendicular. And I'll tell you before we start that this is going to sound way more difficult than it is. So they give us vector u and vector v, and they ask us to decompose u into two vectors where u sub 1 is parallel to v and u sub 2 is orthogonal to v or perpendicular. So by decompose, they just mean break apart. Okay, so let's not let the wording freak us out. So the first thing that I have written here is I have the projection formula. And we're going to use the projection formula to give us the first vector u1 that will be parallel to v. Because notice this is the projection of u onto v. So I'm going to change that and say u1 will be u dot v over the magnitude of v squared times v. Okay, so now we're going to do all that. Okay, so you can see that I kind of went offline there and did the work. I didn't want you to have to watch me write all of the steps out. But there's the dot product over the magnitude of v squared times the magnitude of v. And then I just kept working it. And then here's my ending answer for u sub 1. And so that u sub 1, let's see, 18 over 5 is what? 3 2/5, right? I'm sorry, 3 3/5, right? So 3 and a little bit by 1 and a little bit. So let's see. So that little spot right there is going to be u1. So that's the part of u, that's the part of the decomposition that is parallel to v. Now, the nice thing is to find the perpendicular part, all we have to do is subtract. Because u1 plus u2 should give us vector u. So writing it differently, u minus u1 should give me u2. So I know that u is 5i minus j, and I'm going to subtract what I found for u1, 18 over 5i plus 9/5 j, and that ought to give me u2. Okay, so I went off to do that math a little bit. So remember, this is subtraction, so I needed to change the signs here. So minus, minus, right? And then I went ahead and got a common denominator of 5 here. So I end up with 7/5 I minus 14/5 J, and that's going to be the U2. And if I want to see where that would be on my graph, let's see, 7/5 is just 1 and a little bit, right? And then 14/5 minus 14/5 is down almost 3. So you can see when I do that, there's my u2, and it is indeed perpendicular to v. Remember, this purple guy was perpendicular. Okay, let's do another one. So the instructions are the same here. We're decomposing u into u1 and u2, where u1 is parallel to v and u2 is orthogonal or perpendicular to v. I've already drawn my vectors on there. I know that it doesn't always ask you to draw the vectors, but I always think it's good to kind of give you an idea. And then when you put your, or when you sketch your resultant vectors on there, your u1 and u2, you can kind of be sure that they look parallel and that the other one looks perpendicular, so you can be sure you didn't make some crazy mistake or something. So first, remember that for u1, that's what this projection formula is for finding u1. So I'm going to have u dot v over the magnitude of v squared times v. And I'll go off to the side and do that and be right back. Okay, so u dot v over the magnitude of v squared times v. So just the math getting there. And I end up with negative 7/5 I plus 14/5 j. And so again, this is u1, and this should come out as being parallel to, which is pretty much right on top of, v. So let's see. Negative 7/5 I, so that's going to be negative 1 and a little bit, right? And then 14/5 is almost 3. So negative 1 and a little bit to almost 3. Let's see, where's 3? We'll be good with that for u1. Again, it's not going to be perfect because we don't have all that fractional stuff written down, but it's good to just know, okay, v is in the second quadrant here, and so u1 should also be in the second quadrant if it's parallel, right? So then the next thing is to find u2, and so u2 will be u minus u1. So we'll have 3i plus 5j minus negative 7/5 I, I'm running out of space, plus 14/5 j. All right, I'm going to pop out and fix that. I'll be back in a minute with you two. All right, so again, we had minus a negative, so we distributed that negative in. So we had plus 7/5 I minus 14/5 j. And I got a common denominator there of 5, and we end up with u2 is 22 over 5i plus 11 over 5j. And then if we want to check ourselves up here, let's see, 22 over 5 is going to be 4 and a little bit, right? And 11/5 is going to be just 1 and a smidge. And again, it's not going to be perfect, but I can see that it is somewhat orthogonal, right? So again, don't let these freak you out because the wording sounds so crazy. All you have to do is use this formula to find u1 and then subtract u1 from u to find u2. You got it. Hope you found this helpful.